Oh, head in silent prayer.
Di domo da.
Amen.
In the name of Lord Jesus, we continue with learning of the Word of God. 奉主耶稣基督圣名继续学习神的话语.
Let's sing a hymn, 26.
唱诗26.
Let's pray together.
我们一起祷告。
In the name of Lord Jesus Christ, we pray. Thank you.
Amen. In the name of Lord Jesus Christ, I speak.
奉主耶稣基督圣名讲话。
We are going to continue with our topic, yeah, to discern.
我们继续来讲这个主题要分辨。
Like what we said before, a mature person is one who knows the word of God.
好，就好像之前我们所提到的，一个属灵上面成熟的人他是能够明白神的话语。
Not only he retains the word of God in the mind.
不单单是在他的记忆当中能够这个记得神的这些圣经的经节而已。
He believes the word of God with full conviction.
他可以能够全心的来相信确信神的话语。
So in this way, he knows how to discern what is true and what is not true.
因此用这种方法他能够分辨什么是真理什么不是真理。
And we mentioned two key points.
我们也提到两个重点。
In our daily life, we must be led by the Holy Spirit.
在我们的日常生活当中我们必须由圣灵来引导。
So if we are constantly led by the Holy Spirit,
如果我们总是一直的被圣灵所带领的话。
Even in times of confusion, we find that the Spirit will continue to guide us.
虽然遇到一些这个混乱的事。但是我们知道圣灵会一直的带领我们。
It's like the Spirit will help us navigate a way out of the confusion.
那圣灵可以给我们一个能够带领我们从这个迷惑当中走出去。
We also mentioned that when the Spirit comes, we will enter into the truth.
我们也谈到说当圣灵来了就是要让我们能够引导我们来进入到这个真理当中。
I think there is one more point concerning leading us into the truth that I would like to expound on a bit more.
那我们对于这个圣灵的这个引导我们的真理还有一个部分就是让我们能够更进一步的了解这个真理。
We know that, to enter into the Spirit.
我们知道当我们进入到圣灵里面。
You know, enter into the truth. Yeah, sorry.
或者说那么进入到真理当中。
Not only we believe the word with full conviction.
不单单我们能够以全部的确信来去相信这个神的话语。
We find that naturally this, you know, truth will become our standard of belief.
很自然的真理会成为我们信仰的一个标准。
We will follow that standard to live our life or to conduct ourselves in this world.
我们就跟从这个标准来去在我们的这个生活当中来去带领我们。
We need to understand that if we are in the truth, if we are in the truth,
我们必须明白当我们在真理当中的时候
we'll talk about the truth.
当我们谈论真理的时候
we enjoy talking about the truth.
我们是在谈论真理的时候是很喜悦的很享受的来去谈论真理的。
Because this is like something natural.
那这是很自然的事情。
Because we have known the truth and we want to talk about it.
我们想要把我们所了解到的真理谈论出来。
So when the Bible says the Spirit will lead us into the truth.
所以当圣经讲到说圣灵会引导让我们进入到真理的时候。
We will have a greater understanding of the established truth.
我们要必须明有一个对于真理的建立的一个理解。
对我们已有的真理更加的清楚。
那使得对我们已有的真理更加的清楚。
I want to read Second Peter, yeah?
我们读彼得后书。
Chapter 1.
彼得后书的第一章。
Second Peter chapter 1.
彼得后书的第一章。
Verse 12, yeah?
彼得后书第一章的第十二节。
Second Peter chapter 1 verse 12.
彼得后书第一章的第十二节。
For this reason, I will not be negligent to remind you always of these things.Though you know and are established in the present truth.
你们虽然晓得这些事并且在你们已有的真道上坚固我却要将这些事常常提醒你们。
So here it talks about Peter wanting to remind them.
啊，这里面啊，彼得想要这个总要啊提醒他们。
Concerning you know the established truth, the truth that they have known.
啊，那么来关于这个啊，在已有的真道上来坚固。
So when the Spirit leads us into the truth.
所以当圣灵啊引领我们进入到真理的时候。
We must not think that the Spirit will lead us into, you know, will give us, you know, something very new, which no one has heard before.
啊，我们不要以为说圣灵会给我们一个很一个新的东西啊，是之前啊没有人啊所知道的。
Or is contrary to what we have accepted.
啊，或者是
what we have accepted.
啊，我们啊与我们所领受的啊是相反的。
The Spirit lead us into the present truth.
啊，圣灵啊实际上是引领我们进入到这个真理当中。
So that we can have a deeper understanding of the truth.
那使得我们对真理有一个更深入的了解。
Like when we talk about baptism.
啊，就好像当我们谈论洗礼的时候。
You know, some of us may say this is only for the truth seekers, those who are not members of the true Jesus Church.
啊，那有些人可能会说这是给那些啊这个新受洗的啊这个信徒的。
But in reality, you know, the more we talk about the basic belief.
啊，但是事实上。啊，我们越是谈论啊，这个啊基本的信仰。
Not only we gain a greater understanding of our own beliefs.
啊，不单单我们能够获得对我们所信的啊有个更进一步的了解。
And you will come to realize that actually the entire Bible are in support of the basic beliefs.
啊，你会发觉说整本的圣经都是在支持啊这个基本的信仰。
If you truly believe in that.
啊，那如果你真的这样去相信的话。
You find that you can find, you know, you can use any part of the scriptures actually to back up your own beliefs.
啊，你可以用啊圣经当中的任何的部分的经节来去。作为你信仰的一个支持
，especially when our beliefs are being challenged
啊，尤其是当我们所信的啊被挑战的时候
，you find that you know because we believe in the truth, we are in the truth
啊，因为我们相信真理，我们啊这个在真理当中
，the Spirit will help us to use the scriptures, you know, to diffuse the confusion, if you like
啊，那圣灵就会啊帮助我们用圣经的这个经节。或者是圣经来去啊、来去啊、
驱除
啊、洁净这些迷惑的事情。
You find that your heart is very peaceful and is very settled.
啊，你会发觉说你的心是非常的平安，非常的稳妥的。
Because you know what you believe in.
啊，因为你知道你所信的是什么。
So we should always pray that the Spirit will help us.
啊，所以我们必须要一直的祷告，求神的圣灵来帮助我们。
So that we can truly enter into the truth.
啊，使得我们真的能够进入到真理当中。
Now we are going to look at another example.
啊，我们再来看另外一个例子。
We turn to Second Timothy.
我们再看这个提摩太后书。
This one is similar to First Corinthians chapter 15.
啊，那这同这个格林多前书第十五章是相似的。
We turn to Second Timothy chapter 2.
啊，提摩太后书的第二章。
Second Timothy chapter 2.
提摩太后书第二章。
We read verse 18.
啊，我们来读第十八节。
Second Timothy chapter 2 verse 18.
提摩太后书第二章的第十八节。
Who have strayed concerning the truth, saying that the resurrection is already past? And they overthrow the faith of some.
他们偏离了真道，说复活的事已过，就败坏好些人的信心。
This one is slightly different from the one in First Corinthians chapter 15.
啊，那这一个跟啊同这个格林多前书第十五章当中所提到的有一点不一样。
Because chapter 15 of First Corinthians tells us that there were people who do not believe in the resurrection of the dead.
啊，那么因为在格林多前书第十五章里面谈到的是那些。啊，那有些人啊不相信啊从死里复活的事。
But in Second Timothy
啊，但是在格林多在提摩太后书当中，
Paul is addressing those who claim that resurrection was already passed.
啊，那么保罗啊是谈到说啊复活的事情啊已过。
Now again, yeah, it has to do with the background at the time.
啊，那同时啊，这是跟当时的一个背景有关的。
We always, you know, bring this, you know, this Greek philosophy into the picture.
啊，我们常常这个把这个啊，这个常常跟这个啊，当时的 希腊哲学的思想是有关系的。
They are very repulsive to the ideas of resurrection.
他们对这个复活的事情是非常抵触的。
But here it says that the resurrection is already past.
那在这里面说这个复活的事情已过了。
You know, the believers were confused.
所以这个信主的人就开始觉得很困惑。
For Christian, we believe that there are two resurrections.
那对于基督徒来讲我们会相信两个复活。
The first resurrection occurs in baptism.
那么第一个复活是在洗礼的时候发生的。
So when we rise up from the water, we participate in the resurrection of Christ.
所以当我们从水中出来的时候，我们就与基督的复活相有份。
Meaning that our life is connected back to God.
意思是说我们的生命就与神的生命相连。
That's why Paul says we are given a new lease of life.
所以保罗说我们被赐予了一个新的样式，新生命的样式。
So very likely they identify this with the first resurrection. That's why they said it's past.
所以很显然呢，在这里面指的是第一个复活。这就是为什么说他说这个复活已经过了。
So there's no more, you know, resurrection.
意思是说没有其他复活的事。
Now from here we find that it's like the blended the pure faith, yeah, with, you know, some human philosophies.
所以他们将纯正的信仰同一些人的哲学的思想混合在一起。
That's why this is very important, you know, our belief must be pure, must be purely biblical.
那我们的纯正的信仰必须是纯正的这个符合圣经的。
It must not be blended with other beliefs or other ideas.
我们不应该跟其他的信仰或者是其他的这种想法混为一谈。
We said our belief must be purely Bible based.
意思是说我们所信的必须是纯正的基于圣经的教训。
Now you can look at the detrimental effect.
那如果我们看到这个影响的这个根本的影响是什么呢？
它的破坏很大。
它的破坏很大。
Now if you look at verse 17,
我们看第十七节。
Verse 17,
第十七节。
Here it says, and their message will spread like cancer. Hymenaeus and Philetus are of this sort.
第十七节，他们的话如同毒疮，越烂越大，其中有徐米乃和菲利图。
那个Chinese是毒疮啊。
那中文是那个毒疮。
毒疮 is boils。
那个毒疮如果翻译成英文是boils。
应该是 cancer。
那英文应该是毒瘤才对。
You know, cancer spread very quickly.
因为我们知道说那个毒瘤会癌症会很快的扩散。
That's why my version said their message will spread like cancer.
所以在这里面这个话就好像这个毒瘤这个癌症一样。
Again, when you look at this statement, the resurrection is already past.
所以当我们看这个说复活的事情已过。
You know.Superficially, it doesn't seem harmful.
从表面上
it doesn't seem detrimental to our faith.
所以表面上来看似乎是无害的，对我们的信仰不会造成这个很大的伤害。
But according to Paul, you know, it's like cancer.
但是
it's like a tumor.
但是对保罗来说，那这个话就如同这个毒瘤，如同这个癌症一样。
It can spread and it can kill eventually.
它会扩散开来甚至这个杀害杀害掉人。
True enough, when you read 18, the last part it says they overthrow the faith of some.
所以从十八节的后半部分，我们可以看到提到这个败坏好些人的这个信仰。
So that's why we always say that we cannot tolerate falsehood or false teachings.
所以再一次的，我们可以看到我们不可以容忍这些假的道理、假的教训。
We know that cancer at its initial phase is not easily detectable.
我们知道，作为这个癌症来讲，在它的早期是不容易被察觉到的。
But we know that once we have found out that you know this heresies is spread.
所以当我们已经察觉到的时候，其实这个异端已经被传开了。
We said when we discover this. Radical actions must be taken based on the Bible.
啊，所以当我们发觉到这件事情的毒疮的，当我们发觉到这个毒瘤和癌症的时候，我们必须基于圣经来找到这个治疗的方法。
We must what? If you talk about cancer, then it has to be cut off.
啊，那如果当我们
have to be removed, is it not?
当我们谈到这个癌症的时候，那么这个毒瘤就必须要被去除啊，就会被移除。
That's why you find that Paul actually what?Handed these people to Satan.
啊，所以啊，你可以看到保罗就把这些人交给撒旦。
Meaning that these people were cut off.
啊，那意思是说这些人已经被剪除。
I think sometimes we need to be very sober in our mind.
啊，所以有的时候我们啊，在我们的这个心里面一定要这个警醒。
We put everything aside.
我们要把一些事情放在旁边。
We say we let the Bible speak for itself and see what we can do based on the Bible.
所以我们要让圣经来自己讲话，来看从圣经当中找到这个我们该做的方法。
In the same chapter, yeah, chapter 2.
在这个同样的这个章节当中。
This is what Paul has taught us.
但这是保罗告诉我们的。
In fact, he had shed more light for us to understand.You know, what is the mindset of a person who is deceived?
保罗再一次的让我们看到一个被受了影响的人，他们的这个心思意念是怎么样的。
We can read from verse 24.
我们可以从第24节当中第24节开始读。
Second Timothy chapter 2, verse 24.
提摩太后书第二章的第24节。
And a servant of the Lord must not quarrel, but be gentle to all, able to teach, patient.
然而主的仆人不可争竞，只要温温和和的待众人，善于教导，存心忍耐。
Even when we are dealing with, you know, those who are deceived.
虽然我们在处理那些受迷惑的人。
And you find that this quality of gentleness must be in our hearts.
那这个温和的这个属性必须在我们的心里面。
We must be able to teach and must be very patient.
我们必须要教导必须要忍耐。
In verse 25, this is what Paul says.
那在第25节，这是保罗所告诉我们的。
In humility, correcting those who are in opposition, if God perhaps will grant them repentance so that they may know the truth.
用温柔劝诫那抵挡的人，或者神给他们悔改的心可以明白真道。
So obviously, you know, we hope that, you know, those who are deceived, may repent.
当然我们希望那些受迷惑的人可以能够悔改。
So that they may know the truth.
使得他们能够明白真道。
Now, verse 25 tells us a very important point.
所以在第25节告诉我们一个很重要的一点。
Those who stand in opposition against the truth, against the church.
凡是站在这个抵挡真理和抵挡教会的这个位置的人
，In the eyes of God, they have lost the truth.
在神的眼当中，他们已经失去了真道。
The only way for them to regain the truth is by repenting.
能够使他们才重新获得真道的唯一的方法就是悔改。
They must acknowledge that they have gone against the truth and they must admit their wrongs.
他们必须要知道他们的错误能够悔改，能够归回。
So that they may know the truth.
使得他们能够明白真道。
These people have lost the truth.
因为这些人已经迷失了真道。
That's why we have been saying this.
所以这就是为什么我们这样讲。
When you speak to someone who is deceived.
当你同那些被迷惑的人或被骗的人讲话的时候。
You cannot believe in the words that the person has told you.
你不可以相信那个人同你所讲的话。
Why? Because the person has lost the capacity to tell the truth.
因为那个人已经失去了讲真话的能力。
This is clear in the scriptures.
那这是在圣经当中很清楚的告诉我们。
No matter what the person tells you.
无论这个人对你讲什么。
You cannot believe in all the things that the person said.
你不可以完全相信这个人所对你讲的话。
Because he has lost the truth.
因为他已经失去了真理。
The fact that he has deviated from the truth,
事实上他已经从真道上面迷失了。
Confirm that now what is in the heart is lies.
那在他的心里面所充满的全部都是这些谎言和欺骗。
So the only way for the person to turn back is by repenting.
这个人之所以能够归回唯一的方法就是悔改。
How can the person repent?
一个人怎么样悔改？
When According to the teaching of Paul,
啊，那么根据保罗的教导
，when the person is separated,
啊，当一个人被分离的时候
，perhaps the person might come to his senses,
有可能他们能够意识到这一点
，and then the person will realize that the church is serious about this,
啊，当一个人意识到教会对此非常的严格，或者非常的对这件事情非常的重视的时候
，you know, in this situation, what we need to ask is not about how they feel.
那在这种情况下我们所问的不是他们的感觉是什么。
What we need to ask is, have we done the right things for the church?
我们所问的应该是我们有没有为教会做出正确的决定。
So have we helped to safeguard the brothers and sisters?
我们有没有来去保护好我们的统领我们的弟兄姐妹。
That is our major concern.
这是我们主要所要关注的问题。
Because someone who has been deceived,
因为当一个人被迷惑被欺骗的时候
the person can bean actor better than the best actor in Hollywood.
这个人可能表现出来的比在好莱坞电影所表那个表演者所表现出来的演出来的更好，演技更好。
Because the driving force behind is Satan.
因为在背后所驱使的力量是从撒旦而来的。
So we must ask ourselves.
所以我们必须要问我们自己。
Putting everything aside.
把一切都放在旁边。
We ask ourselves.
我们要问我们自己。
Have we done the right thing?
我们有没有做出正确的我们有没有做的正确
？Is our decision in accordance to the scriptures?
我们的决定是不是基于圣经
？This is what we should be concerned about.
这是我们所要关注的问题。
Now we look at the chapter 2 again.
我们再来看第二章。
Now verse 26.
第二十六节。
And that they may come to their senses and escape the snare of the devil, having been taken captive by him to do his will.
叫他们就已经被魔鬼任意掳去的可以醒悟脱离他的网络。
Taken captive by the devil.
那这个被魔鬼掳去的。
To do whose will?
是这个是。
成就谁的旨意？
是成就谁的旨意呢
？The will of the devil.
实际上是成就魔鬼的旨意。
So those who have been deceived.
那些已经迷惑受骗的。
They have been taken captive by the devil to do the will of the devil.
他们已经被魔鬼掳去来遵从他魔鬼的旨意。
That's why they spread, untruth in the church.
那这就是他们为什么在教会当中散布那些不真实的谎言。
You know, someone who is in his right frame, right spiritual frame of mind.
那么有些人在在他们的心思意念当中有一个属灵的框架。
有一个正确的属灵框架。
一个正确的属灵框架。
You know, the person will not tell you that, oh, you don't need to pray for the Holy Spirit.
那这个人不会告诉你说你不需要求圣灵。
So it tells us that the person frame of mind, spiritually speaking, is corrupt.
如果一个人跟你讲说不需要求圣灵，那证明说他在属灵里面的这个属灵框架已经塌陷了。
You must not look at the expression of the person. Forget about it. Put it aside.
你不要从他的这个一个人的这个表达或表面的这些表现、表情来去看这个人，要把这些东西放在两边。
And we ask ourselves, have we done the right thing to help the church?
而是我们要问我们自己说，我们有没有为教会做出正确的决定，做出正确的做法。
In this way, we will be able to discern very accurately by the mercy of God.
那么我们才能够借着神的慈悲和怜悯，能够分辨的清楚。
Now we come back.、Yeah?
我们再看回来。
So some people's faith have been overthrown.
那有些人的这个信心呢已经被败坏了。
So the message is like cancer, it spread like cancer.
所以这个话呢就好像这个毒疮就好像这个毒瘤一样，越烂越大。
And then we need to ask the question, why is it that the members, yeah, some of them were affected?
那我们会问一个问题，为什么其中的一些信徒会受到影响呢？
I want you to read the verse 16.
我们来读第十六节。
Verse 16.
第十六节。
Verse 16.
第十六节。
But shun profane and idle babbling, for they will increase to more ungodliness.
但要远避世俗的虚谈，因为这的人必进到更不敬虔的地步。
We read the verse chapter 6 of First Timothy.
我们再来看提摩太前书的第六章。
First Timothy chapter 6.
提摩太前书的第六章。
We read verse 20.
我们再读第二十节。
Chapter 6 verse 20.
提摩太前书第六章二十节。
All Timothy, guard what was committed to your trust, avoiding the profane and idle babblings and contradiction of what is falsely called knowledge. By professing it, some have strayed concerning the faith. Grace be with you. Amen.
第二十节，提摩太啊，你要保守所托付你的，躲避世俗的虚谈和那敌真道似是而非的学问。第二十一节，已经有人自称有着学问，就偏离了真道。愿恩惠常与你们同在。阿门。
Here Paul told Timothy to guard what has been committed to him to his trust.
那在这里面这个保罗要提摩太来保守所托付你的。
One of the things that Timothy must do is not to engage in this kind of a profane and idle babblings.
那么提摩太所要做的其中一个很重要要做的就是不要躲避这个世俗的虚谈。
Because this will increase to more ungodliness.
因为这个世俗的虚谈会让人进到更不敬虔的地步。
We know that the truth is in accordance to godliness.
那我们知道说这个真理呢是基于这个敬虔的。
So you find that if we associate with things that are not godly,
如果你与这些世俗的不敬虔的事物那么相关的话
you find that the truth in our hearts will be devalued.
那你可以看到这个在你心里面的真理呢就会这个贬值。
It's like the truth is no longer important to you.
意思是说呢这个真理对你来讲呢就会变得不再重要。
We use the truth to what? To discern, to safeguard ourselves.
我们用真理来去分辨，来去保护我们自己。
Now you can imagine if the truth is no longer important to you.
如果假设你想说这个真理已经对你不再重要了。
Because you always talk about things which are profane, which are evil and not good.
那么如果假设你总是在谈论那些世俗的事，那些恶事，那些不好的事。
Then how can you discern? You can't discern anymore.
你怎么样去分辨呢？你不可能分辨的。
So quite clearly, the way we live our life also has a direct bearing on the way we discern, matters concerning the truth.
所以实际上我们的生活方式会成为关于我们能否在真理上面能得到分辨的一个阻拦。
So it's very important.
这是很重要的。
I guess this is something that perhaps we need to pay careful attention to.
所以我想说这是我们要特别的去留意的一件事。
Now I also want you to read verse 15, back to chapter 2.
我们再看回提摩太后书第二章的第十五节。
Chapter 2 verse 15.
提摩太后书第二章的第十五节。
Be diligent to present yourself approved to God, a worker who does not need to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth.
你当竭力在神面前得蒙喜悦，做无愧的工人，按着正义分解真理的道。
So if we can rightly divide the word of truth,
如果我们能够真的按正义分解真理的道，
then surely we can discern.
我们当然就能够分辨。
But how can we rightly divide the truth?
我们怎么样能够按着正义来分解真理的道？
It's not about studying the methods of exposition, how to explain the Bible.
那么
it's not just about that.
我们不单单只是学说怎么样去解释圣经的这个方法而已。
I think here it tells us something very important.
那在这里面其实提到一个很重要的事情。
We must be approved to God in His eyes.
意思是说我们必须在神的眼当中来去得蒙神的喜悦。
Be diligent to present ourselves approved to God.
能够竭力的来去在神面前得蒙他的喜悦。
Meaning that whatever we have done, whatever we said is pleasing to him.
意思是我们所做所说所行都能够得到神的喜悦。
Oh, and our entire self is in pursuit of pleasing the Lord.
我们整个的却这个我一切都是为了这个得蒙神的喜悦。
In this way, you find that we can divide the truth very accurately.
那你如果这样做的话，你可以发觉说，你可以按照正义分解真理的道。
Because whatever we speak, we don't speak for ourselves.
因为我们所讲的不是为我们自己讲而已。
Sometimes we speak the truth.
有的时候当我们讲说真理的时候。
We afraid that we might offend others.
我们会害怕说我们会冒犯其他的人。
It's like our interest is at stake.
这可能是这个
我们的利益，
那可能我们的利益受到损伤。
Therefore, we don't speak the truth anymore. We keep
keep quiet.
啊，意思，所以我们啊不再讲说真理，我们就保持沉默。
In the eyes of God, we are not an approved worker.
啊，那么在神的眼当中，我们就不能够成为这个啊无愧的工人。
Because our heart is not pure.
啊，因为我们的心不纯正。
So if our heart is pure,
如果我们的心是纯正的
，even God, recognizes that our heart is pure.
啊，那么甚至啊神能够啊。看到我们的内心是纯正的。
So when we speak the word of God,
啊，当我们讲说神的话的时候
，we can speak the word of God and explain the word of God accurately.
啊，我们就能够讲说，并且能够解释神的很准确的来解释神的话。
This is something that cannot be taught. We have to cultivate ourselves.
啊，这不是用讲就可以能够啊讲明白的，这是我们要靠灵修来得到的。
So that we know exactly how to discern.
啊，使得我们能够知道怎么样啊去分辨。
Especially in difficult circumstances.
啊，尤其是啊，当我们遇到这个很困难的情况的时候。
But if we are approved workers of God.
啊，如果我们啊是啊神无愧的工人。
We find that we are not afraid.
啊，我们就发觉说我们是不会惧怕的。
We are able to continue to discern what is right and what is wrong.
啊，我们会继续的来去分辨啊，来分辨是非。
Now I also want you to read this chapter 3, Second Timothy chapter 3.
我们再来看提摩太后书的第三章。
We read verse 10.
提摩太后书第三章的第十节。
Chapter 3 verse 10.
提摩太后书第三章的第十节。
But you have carefully followed my doctrine, manner of life, purpose, faith, long suffering, love, and perseverance.
但你已经服从了我的教训、品行、志向、信心、宽容、爱心、忍耐。
11.
第十一节。
Persecution, affliction which happened to me at Antioch, at Iconium, and Lystra, what persecution I endured, and out of them all the Lord delivered me.
以及我在安提阿、以哥念、路斯德所遭遇的逼迫苦难，我所忍受是何等的逼迫，但从这一切苦难中，主都把我救了出来。
Here, Paul talks about, Timothy following his doctrines.
保罗这里谈到提摩太服从了这个教训。
In fact, he also followed the manner of life shown by Paul.
那也能够这个服从这个保罗所这个向他显的这个品行。
And also, persecution, affliction that Paul has suffered.
那么同时是保遭遇了到了保罗所这个遭遇到的这个这个痛苦难和逼迫。
Meaning that Timothy is like living, a life which is identical to that of Paul.
意思是说，这个提摩太会这个过着一个与保罗一样的这个人生。
We find that this life is to please God, is to fulfill the will of God.
我们看到说这个人生是这个让神得喜悦的，并且是这个来去这个遵从来去遵从神旨意的人生。
So by following that example,
那么来跟从这些这个榜样。
We find that Timothy likewise was able to discern as well, just like Paul did.
那么就因为提摩太跟从这个榜样，那么提摩太也好像保罗一样能够分辨。
So it's not just about listening to the word.
所以这绝对不单单只是听神的话语而已。
Our manner of life and our determination to suffer for Christ must be there as well.
我们的心思意念，我们为神这个受苦难受逼迫的这种决心，也必须要在那里。
Now we look at First Timothy chapter 4.
我们再来看这个提摩太前书的第四章。
First Timothy chapter 4.
提摩太前书的第四章。
Verse 13,
第十三节。
Verse 13,
提摩太前书第四章第十三节。
Till I come, give attention to reading, to exhortation, to doctrine. Do not neglect the gift that is in you, which was given to you by prophecy, with the laying on of the hands of the eldership. Verse 15,
第十五节。
Meditate on these things, give yourself entirely to them, that your progress may be evidence to all.Verse 16,
第十六节。
Take it to yourself and to the doctrine, continue in them, for in doing this you will save both yourself and those who hear you.
第十四节，你不要轻忽所得的恩赐，就是从前。
十
第十三节，你要 第十三节，你要以宣读、劝勉、教导为念，只等到我来。第十四节，你不要轻忽所得的恩赐，就是从前借着预言在众长老按手的时候赐给你的。第十五节，这些事你要殷勤去做，并要在此专心，使众人看出你的长进来。第十六节，你要谨慎自己和自己的教训，要在这些事上恒心，因为这样行又能救自己，又能救听你的人。
Here Paul is like, you know, he gave an exhortation to Timothy.
那在这里保罗给提摩太这个一些这个勉励和建议。
To help him focus on the right thing.
使得他能够专注在正确的事上面。
To give attention to reading exhortation, and my version said to doctrine. The last one is doctrine.
那这里面讲到宣读劝勉，这个教导，那这个英文的版本就是教义。
And meditate on these things.
能够在这些方面能够反复的思想。
And give yourself entirely to them.
把自己完全的献给他们。
So you know sometimes if we want to help ourselves and to stay clear of deception.
那如果我们有的时候说我们要使我们免得受到这个迷惑。
You know, the things that we focus on, yeah, can have an impact on us as well.
有些时候我们所专注的一些事情对我们也是有影响的。
If we focus on the matters of God, the truth of God.
那如果我们专注在这个神的事上真理的事上。
And the pursuit of the truth.
来去追求真理的话。
You find that, yeah, we can be protected by God in times of, confusion.
那么在这个迷惑的时候神的真理那么我们就可以被这个真理所保护。
Because we have the truth, of God to safeguard ourselves.
因为我们有这个真理能够保护我们。
That's why Paul said to Timothy, he must take heed to himself and to the doctrine.
这就是为什么保罗劝勉提摩太，你要谨慎自己和自己的教训。
So you find that this is the way to guard against this falsehood.
那这就是我们看到。
And to discern as well.
我们看到怎么样去这个谨防这些迷惑和如何分辨。
Like what we said, yeah, this thing will continue to increase.
就好像之前我们提到的那这些事将会不断的更多的发生。
So that we need the word of God, we need the word of God to help us.
我们需要神的道来帮助到我们。
Now we look at another example.
我们再来看另外一个例子。
We turn to, Second Peter.
我们来看彼得后书。
We turn to Second Peter.
彼得后书。
We read chapter 3.
我们读第三章。
Second Peter chapter 3.
彼得后书第三章。
We read verse 4.
彼得后书第三章的第四节。
Verse 4?
第四节。
And saying, where is the promise of his coming? For since the fathers fell asleep, all things continue as they were from the beginning of creations.
主要降临的应许在哪里呢？因为从列祖睡了以来，万物与起初创造的时候仍是一样。
Here obviously it talks about the second coming of Christ, the promise concerning the second coming of Christ.
那么这里面提到这个主第二次再来的应许。
Some people challenge this promise of the Lord.
那么有些人来挑战主第二次再来的应许。
So where is the promise of his coming?
那他们说主要这个降临的应许在哪里呢？
You see, you know, our father has fallen asleep.
他们说这个列祖已经好，已经睡了。
All things remains the same from the beginning of creation until now.
所以万物与起初创造的时候都是一样的。
It's like saying that there is no such thing called the second coming of Christ.
那意思是说呢没有主第二次再来的应许。
Now, if you look at this passage again,
那如果我们再来去看这一节经节
you find that this, you know, this idea actually is promoted by a group of people.
你会发觉说这样的这个想法是被一些人所传讲的。
And Peter called them the scoffers.
那彼得呢就告诉彼得把他们叫做这个不敬虔之人。第三节讥笑好讥笑的人。
We read verse 3.
我们来读第三节。
Verse 3.
第三节。
Knowing this first, that scoffers will come in the last day, walking according to their own lusts.
第一要紧的，该知道在末世必有好讥诮的人，随从自己的私欲出来讥诮说。
I want to read Proverbs.
我们来读箴言。
Chapter 9.
箴言的第九章。
We read verse 7.
箴言第九第九章的第七节。
Verse 7. Not this one. Verse 7, okay. Now he who correct a scoffer get himself shameful. Gets shame for himself, and he will rebuke a wicked man, only harms himself.
指斥亵慢人的必受辱骂，责备恶人的必被玷污。
You find that, you know, a scoffer does not listen.
你可以看到说这个好讥诮的人是不会听的。
Okay, we turn to chapter 21.
我们再看回这个我们看到这个第二十一章。
Proverbs chapter 21.
箴言的第二十一章。
We read verse 24.
我们读第21章的第24节。
Proverbs 21 verse 24.
箴言21章的第24节。
A proud and haughty man, scoffer is his name. He acts with arrogant pride.
心骄气傲的人名叫亵慢，他行事狂妄，都出于骄傲。
This is the nature of a scoffer.
但这是好讥诮的人的一个这个性本性。
He is proud and he is haughty.
他是心骄气傲的。
And the Bible says he acts with arrogant pride.
那圣经记载说他行事狂妄。
He is so proud that he even denied trying to remove the promise of God.
他们如此的骄傲，甚至他们可以能够将神的应许移除掉。
That's why quite clearly, you know, the scoffers in Second Peter.
所以很清楚的在彼得后书里面所提到的好讥诮的人
about people who, you know, who were very arrogant,
是那些狂傲的
they even challenged the promise of the Lord,
甚至来去挑战这个神的应许
that's why they are deceived by their own pride,
所以他们被他们自己的骄傲所欺骗
they could not see, you know, the promise of the Lord,
他们没有办法看到神的应许
you know, how do we know that this promise is true?
我们怎么会知道这个应许是真的
When you read this chapter, Second Peter,
当我们读这个彼得后书这个章节的时候
We can gather some points based on that chapter.
我们可以从这个章节当中这个得到一些要点。
If you read verse 1, here it says,
那如果我们读第一节这里面说
Peter said, I stir up your pure minds, pure minds by way of reminder.
彼得说呢是提醒你们来激发你们诚实的心
pure minds
这个是诚实的心就是纯正的心
we know that when we come to believe in the truth
所以当我们这个开始相信真理的时候
or when we receive the Holy Spirit
是当我们领受圣灵的时候
we are given a heart of purity
我们就被赐予一个这个纯洁的心
You find that this heart is very receptive to the word of God
你会发觉说这个心对于神的话语是非常愿意领受的
Whatever is spoken based on the Bible
无论只要是基于圣经的这个话语被讲出
You find that this heart will be able to receive
你可以看到这样的心就愿意去领受
That's why Paul said to the members in Corinth
那这就是我们看到保罗对这个格林多教会的信徒讲
He feared that, you know, this simplicity that is in Christ Jesus might be lost
那么他害怕说这个信徒对神纯正话语的心已经失去了
I want you to read chapter 11, yeah? Second Corinthians chapter 11
我们来读这个格林多后书的第十一章。
Chapter 11, we read verse 3.
格林多后书第十一章的第三节。
Chapter 11, verse 3.
格林多后书第十一章的第三节。
But I fear lest someone as the serpent deceive Eve by his craftiness, so your mind may be corrupted from the simplicity that is in Christ.
格林多后书第十一章的第三节。我只怕你们的心或偏于邪，失去那像基督所存。纯一清洁的心就像蛇用诡诈诱惑了夏娃一样
This simplicity that is in Christ can be lost
那这个对像基督所存像基督所存纯一清洁的心可能会失去
when a person, especially when a person is deceived
尤其是当一个人被 欺骗的时候。
So that's why Peter said to them.
啊，这就是为什么彼得啊来告诉他们。
We have been given this pure mind from the very beginning.
啊，我们已经从起初啊领受了这个纯一清洁的心。
That's why Peter said, I would like to stir up your pure mind.
啊，这就是彼得为什么说我们要这个啊激发你们啊这个纯洁的心。
By way of reminder.
啊，那么来借着提醒来激发他们。
Obviously, you know, Peter used the word of God to stir up their pure mind.
啊，那么显然彼得是要用神的话语来去啊激发他们的这个啊清洁的心。
Sometimes we find that when this purity of heart is not there.
啊，有的时候当我们发觉说这个诚实的心，这个清洁诚实的心不在那里的时候。
Listening to the word of God is like, you know, like the music to the ears.
啊，那么这个。听神的话语就好像这个听音乐一样，听了就过去的意思。
It's like it won't have an impact on you.
啊，意思是说你听了就过去啊，不会对你产生任何的影响。
Why? Because the heart is so pure.
因为你的心不纯洁清一不纯纯一清洁。
That's why Peter said, "I'm going to stir up your pure mind."
啊，这就是为什么彼得说啊，他要激发。啊，他们的心。
By using obviously the word of God.
啊，那是借着啊神的话语来提醒他们。
You know, sometimes when we speak to people who are deceived.
啊，那有的时候当我们同那些受迷惑的人讲话的时候。
They will tell you, I don't agree with this doctrine.
啊，他会跟你讲说我不同意这个啊这个教义。
I don't agree with you on this point.
啊，或者是说他不同意啊在这一点上不同意你。
Even though this has been preached.You know, by the church for ever since the establishment of the church.
啊，那么甚至这些啊，是甚至在教会在建立的时候，就在成立的时候就已经啊所传讲的道理。
How is it that you know they show sign of disagreement?
啊，那为什么他们能够显示出这个不啊这个不同意的这个啊这个迹象呢？
It's not that they have received new truth. No.
啊，这并不代表着说他们领受了一个这个新的道理。
Simply because the simplicity of the heart has been lost.
啊，那么很简单的就是他们纯一清洁的心已经失去了。
所以 they cannot accept the truth.
啊，那就是为什么他们没有办法能够领受真理。
Sometimes when you speak the truth, yeah.
啊，有的时候当你啊讲说真理的时候
，you find that they can't even sit properly.
啊，你会看到说他们甚至连坐都坐不住。
坐立不安。
啊，坐立不安，如坐针毡。
翻译的人他听不懂，
好像坐在针上一样。
Sit on the needles. This is what he said.
不翻，
是不是这样？对。Can't sit properly. Why? Because the heart is not at peace.
啊，因为啊没有办法啊，是因为他们的心啊不平安。
They have lost the simplicity in Christ Jesus.
啊，他们在基督里面已经失去了啊纯一清洁的心。
You know.We have been given this soul. We must keep this heart of purity.
啊，我们既然已经领受了，我们就应该啊持守住这个纯一清洁的心。
So once we lost this, then we will begin to what? To disagree with everything that the church preaches.
如果我们失去了这个心，我们就会开始啊这个反对教会所传讲的啊
everything that the church does. You know, you find that these people would.Would disagree.
啊，凡是教会所做的，这些人都会不同意。
Because they have lost the purity of the.
啊，因为他们已经失去了啊这个啊这个纯一的心。
Now we come back to chapter 3.
我们再看回彼得后书的第三章。
This is what Peter said of this people. Said of this scoffers.
啊，那这就是彼得怎么样去同这些好讥诮的人说话。
We read verse 5.
我们来读第五节。
For this they willfully forget.That by the word of God the heavens were of old and the earth standing out of water and in the water.
他们故意忘记从太古凭神的命有了天，并从水而出，借水而成的地。
Actually, they knew about this.
啊，其实事实上他们知道的。
It's by the word of God that you know the heaven was created and was sustained until now.
啊，那么借着神的道啊，那么有了天，并且呢啊这个啊这个这个这个。这个一直到现在。
But it's like they willfully forget mean they like they suppress the truth.
啊，那意思是故意忘记，实际上就是说他们啊来去这个压迫真理。
It's like you know they don't want to know about this truth.
啊，意思是说他们就不想要啊 知道真理。
So when you read the Romans, yeah.
所以当我们读罗马书的时候。
What would happen to a person who suppresses the truth?
那么对一个这个压迫真理的人在他们身上发生了什么事呢？
We turn to chapter 1.
我们来看这个罗马书的第一章。
Verse 18.
第十八节。
Chapter 1, verse 18.
第一章的第十八节。
For the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness and unrighteousness of men who suppress the truth in unrighteousness.
原来神的愤怒从天上显明在一切不谦不义的人身上，就是那些行不义敌阻挡真理的人。
So God's wrath will come upon these people.
那神的愤怒将临到这些人的身上。
Verse 19.
第十九节。
Because what may be known of God is manifested in them, for God has shown it to them.
神的事情人所能知道的原显明在人心里，因为神已经给他们显明。
So in the case of 2 Peter,
那在这个 chapter 3, 在这个彼得后书第三章当中的这个例子。
They have been taught this truth of God.
他们已经这个被教导这个神神的真理。
But they suppress the truth.
但是他们却阻挡真理。
Why? Because their hearts no longer pure and simple.
因为他们的心已经不再纯一清洁。
So, you know, to safeguard ourselves and not to fall into deception.
要想保守我们的心不会陷入到这个迷惑和欺骗当中。
Or to help ourselves to discern.
能够帮助我们来去分辨。
Keeping a heart of purity is of utmost important.
那么能够持守我们纯一清洁的心是显然是非常非常重要的。
You know, the way we deal with things.
我们所处理这个事情的这个方法。
Our interaction with one another.
我们彼此交通的这个互动的这个彼此交通的这个方式。
And our relationship with God.
那么以及我们同神之间的关系。
Must come from a heart of purity.
我们都是要从我们这个诚实的心纯一清洁的心而来的。
In this way, we find that we can firmly, you know, steadfastly stand in the truth.
那么这样我们才能够在这个真理上面站立得住。
We will not